Left wheels are on one.
And there's the wheels on both semi, of them, I see.
And the right wheels are on the other semi.
Holy smokes.
I don't know where that truck went to.
Was it around the mines, though, huh?
Yeah, it came. I think I know where it came from, but where it went to, I don't know. To another mine around there somewhere. Yep. And now, you know, they got one of those big trucks on display just west of, or east of, east of Virginia.
Up on a hill?
Up on
a
hill.
Yeah,
on
a, yeah.
Yeah, they call it the viewpoint in the sky.
Yeah.
You know, that's up there.
Mm-hmm.
That's where it's at. It's wore out, the one they got, they said. Oh. So it wasn't used anymore. So they put it up there for display. Yeah, viewpoint in the sky.
So what did you do over there?
What did I do?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Drilling holes for blasting. Blasting the rock. It's got pictures of drills in there.
Okay.
I can find them where I come.
What did you drill with, anyway?
Well, in a way. It had them here. Well, there's one of the drills that I worked on, and that was 50 feet up to the crow's nest. And over the years, I was up there a few times over the years, you know, went up there for some reason or another. And we had an awful hill to work on, so they used a D8 cat to help move that drill up and down. When you stopped to drill a hole, you didn't unhook, because otherwise it might slide, you know.
Yeah.
So they had to leave it hooked up.
Mm.
Yeah. And the cat up there, he had to find a flat spot or some kind of a dip, so he wouldn't pull himself down against the drill, you know, when he's pulling.
Mm. Yeah.
You see, he'd been pulling the winch. He used the winch, you know. Yeah.
Mm. So then after they were blasted, then...
Afterwards they blasted, yeah.
Then what happened to them? What happened?
They hauled it to the mill where it was ground up and separated, you know.
This was iron?
Yeah.
Or, I mean?
Yeah, it had about 30% iron in that rock.
Mm.
And it was ground up.
Taconite, okay.
Yeah, it was taconite, yeah. Well, I worked up in up there on the Lost River one winter. And that was cedar poles. When we got done, we had 10,700 poles out that winter.
Oh, my.
Boy.
Yeah. You know, I could eat pretty good, too.
Oh, yeah? Then you had good cooks, did you?
Oh, yeah. We,
cook shack?
I know one time, you know, the fellow that owned the outfit was from Norton. Tony Lundberg was the name.
Mm-hmm.
And, at noon, you know, and the cook says, Tony forgot to bring me milk, and I can't cook with milk. You know, he had milk for supper to cook with. Yep.
Oh.
And it was must have been 30 miles. Anyway, one way. And, you know, the logging roads, you don't go with speed on them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, good and nothing out. No.
Yeah.
So somebody went to get it, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, the cook had milk for supper. Oh, yeah. There we are. I don't know. I can't see too good. I can look at those first two. You can tell what's going on.
What the heck?
What? That's some kind of a...
You got a cat flipped upside down there?
Yeah. That's a
cat
on its side.
How did that happen?
Was Stanton had done that.
Oh, really?
You know, I'd come just 5 minutes before that happened. And what he was doing, he had a pulpwood trailer up against a pile of pulpwood, and then he was up in there on the pulpwood with the cat, and going from there to under the trailer. Well, when he got on the trailer, the thing slid off, and him with it. Well, you know, I heard the racket, but I didn't see it. But but then I heard he was disgusted. Well, then I knew he was all right, you know.
Yeah.
And I heard the racket when it went. Well, then you see, they went to another camp nearby for them to come with their cat to upright that one. And there's more pictures that shows where they're...
How many camps did they have?
Camps?
Yeah. Several? Yeah. Camps.
Camps? I don't know what was around. I only knew about that. The other one, I don't know, was nearby, but I couldn't tell you where it was. I don't know where it came from. Mm. But it couldn't have been very far away. It was somewhere in the area. That's all that I know. But anyway...
Oopsie.
He says, I only got myself to blame.
Yeah, good thing it was him, huh?
Yeah, that's right. Good thing it was him.
Yeah.
Well, by 10 o'clock that night, they had that cat running again.
Oh, did they?
Yeah, he had a garage. They pulled it into there, and he worked on it. And I imagine he lost some antifreeze. He must have. And some transmission fluid, probably, you know. And it went into the...
So where all did you teach, I mean?
Oh, I started in Pleasant Valley.
Okay.
And then I went to Redby.
Mm-hmm.
And then to Carlston.
Really?
And then to Crookston.
What did you teach?
First grade, first and second, depending on where I was.
Yeah.
You don't remember when the government cattle were shipped in here?
Government cattle?
Yeah. You probably don't remember that.
What was that? How come? During the 30s? Or?
Yeah. Yeah, you see, North Dakota and South Dakota were dried out, and they brought in a whole bunch of cattle, and I was here when they unloaded cattle in Kellyer. They had stock pens where they unloaded them, but from where they went from there, I don't know. But, and I remember when I was in Black Duck one time, there was a train of several cars, of cattle cars went by. And one time there was a herd of cattle 5 miles north of Black Duck. They were going north. So where they went to, I don't know.
So then people could take them and raise,
yeah, they'd take
raise them.
Yeah, they'd take off, I don't know how many. And then herded them, you know. Mm-hmm. And they were allowed a percentage loss, But sometimes I think the loss was kind of intentional, too, you know.
Yeah.
You know, it wasn't all natural.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, did the people that raised them then from then on get to sell them or
no, I imagine they got, I don't know how it worked, but they got so much. For how long a time, I don't know.
I see. Kind of like renting the land.
Yeah. And there must have been designated areas where they went to, where they could send them to, so they could graze, you know.
I've never heard of that.
Yeah. Kellyer had they had stopped and sweat. When we were there, we didn't stay around to see where they went with them, but there was about 40 some head in a car, I think it was, in a car load of cattle. Yep. And the day we were there, there was a sun kink in the rail, if you know what a sun kink is.
Mm-hmm.
And I watched them when they cut that chunk out of there.
Oh, really?
They used to, they didn't have torches, you know, they used wedges of some sort.
Hmm.
Cut out and put a new piece in.
You mean the sun made the rail expand or something?
Made a bow, you know.
Oh.
So they had to replace it before they could move those cars, you know. Yeah. And then they had a building for the locomotive where that's at.
Mm.
And that locomotive, that was a combination of a locomotive, a passenger, and express, and mail, and one car, you know.
Mm.
That came down there.
Went
from Kellyer to Bemidji.
Yeah.
Okay.
Two shooks?
That was in the early 30s, yeah. Mm. Yeah. And then when Kellyer had that big fire south of west of Shooks. That whole country was on fire one time.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
1938. And I remember 7 miles west of Shooks, we could see that smoke.
Mm-hmm.
And it started in the afternoon and the south wind and jumped number one.
Oh, really?
And and hit for Kellyer. Well, I understood they took the high school boys out for the fire, is what I heard. But when they got to the south, Corman, that's as far as it went.
Mm-hmm.
Fire stopped there. and I was on that firefighting. We were trying to keep it from spreading wider, you know, on the sides.
Yeah.
And then there was a fire northeast of Killier at the same time.
Oh, really?
So we went up there, but
was it dry or something, or what?
Yeah,
was the deal?
It was dry, you know, and wind, you know. I can't remember how long. I think it was only a day or two. Then we got a little drizzly weather, and then that was the end of that, and then they didn't need us anymore.
Mm.
Yeah.
Thank goodness, huh?
Yeah. Yeah.
Was that in 38, too?
That was, I would have to stop. I would say about 38, yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. Yeah.
I know I was in high school, kind of my first year. Anyway, all the boys went.
Well, they did.
So it was kind of quiet.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, yeah,